Hey, what's up guys? Today's video we will play one live meta match. We're currently at 8000 trophies. We want to get another win and I'm gonna show that after that hopefully the best games I had on my road to the 8000 trophies. We're playing currently some different minor warfare deck. I'm kind of switching around. This is the deck we're gonna play today because I think overall against the decks I'm facing in top level, I have the best matchups of the separation. A lot of minor warfare players with fireball like Moogie, Mormet Light, Wolfstochter, so I really think Zap is really good in top ladder, but before that, until I pushed it onto the top 8k, I used the Hunter variation instead of the Bats and the Fireball instead of the Zap. Reason was so much Larvon and so much Beatdown in general. So if you guys start with Beatdown, put Hunter in it, we're gonna show you replay soon. And if you're playing against a lot of spell bait decks, a lot of Spat cycle decks in general, use the Zap variation. If you guys gonna support me or wants to support me, don't forget to use creator code mod in the shop. Subscribe to the channel, it's really easy to do. Just click on the subscription button, really helps me out. We are on our way to the 75,000 subscriber. I'm gonna love you guys still. What I'm talking about, I would say. Let's get into the game. Can we get another win? We would, with the win, we would even maybe get a top 10 global. Let's go, guys. Here we go, guys. Here in the game. Oh, wait. We play against one of the best in the world. We play against Moogie. Good luck to Moogie. And he's playing Minor Wall Breaker. So, we are playing here the Bats variation, the Zap variation, because I think I'm not really sure which is better. I'm kinda switching around with decks right now currently, so I'm not really sure which is better, but I think, I mean, there are not many lava players right now, so I'm deciding to play this one. I think we're just gonna spin. So I think we get one connection, but it's fine, honestly. So he's gonna lock this, we're gonna wall breaker. Is he gonna bond tower that? We should have a huge matchup advantage as long as he doesn't have the Zap also. I mean, if he has Zap, then it's a mirror matchup. But I think he's playing Fireball, so we should have a good matchup. That's what I think, at least. So, I think we are going in with the Bats in the back. I don't really think he knows that we have Zap. So, I'm kind of always trying to switch decks around, like, for not getting sniped and stuff. Because I don't really want to get sniped. I think it makes sense to you. So, we're doing this. He's gonna lock and knight, which is fine. We go off bats. He's also going off bats, so we need to zap this. And I don't really think he expected that from me to have zap. So we go for knight in front of that. We go for lock. And we are gonna drop spear goblins. Spear Goblins are coming down. He's playing really well so far, but I think in double Elixir time especially, we should have a huge matchup advantage over him. So we're just gonna play carefully here and yeah, just to make sure we get it up, we get it down. Okay, we have Wall Breaker ready. We go for Miner. Let's see if he's gonna catch it. Yes, he did. Okay, fine. We go for my Knight in the back. Let's see. Problem is that he can fireball cycle us, so we need to be careful of that. So we're gonna lock this, we're gonna miner, we're gonna knight, zap, wall breaker, spear goblins. Okay, he's also doing this. This is like an interesting overcommit by him. So we go for miner in the back. Let's see, how is he gonna defend this? Is he even gonna defend this? I don't really think he can, so we're gonna lock this. And we're gonna zap that. So we should be fine. Miner's getting a ton of damage on the right side. We go with Wall Breaker. We go with Spear Goblins. We go with Bats, and we go for Miner. We go for Lock. And we go with Wall Breaker also on the opposite side. He's kinda low on Elixir, he still needs to lock that, but we're up by a ton. So the Spear Goblin might connect. No, they're not. So you need to go with Bats. We need to go for a miner. We go for Zap. Like, he's doing really great miner catches. He's like almost catching every miner from us, which is not optimal. Great Spear Goblin placement. So we're gonna lock this. Okay, Lock is doing well. Lock is doing a fine job for us. So what are we gonna do next here? I think we wanna support the knight, but also wanna pressure on the miner. Wall breaker side. Log. The bats are connecting like a ton of chip damage, but we are kind of splitting our damage here, which shouldn't be our goal, but we wanna kind of push opposite lane here. So we go for Miner on the left. Don't really wanna push same lane. So Miner chipping away. So we're gonna lock this, we're gonna zap. We're gonna bats here, we're gonna Miner. We're gonna wall breaker here. He's gonna bomb tower that, so we wanna Miner once again. We're gonna zap this. We're gonna go with Knight in the back. Lock this, lock, zap. We're taking it up. Let's go. We won against Moogie, one of the best players in the world. Good game, GG's. We talked it up. Let's go, guys. What an insane game against Moogie. We got a plus 30 trophies. We are currently, I think we should be really high right now. We are top 11 on the season. On the world, in the world, that's just insane, and I will try to get the number 10 finish or like top 10 global finish this season. I would say I'm gonna show you like some replays. I played like different Miner controllers, as you see. I did like a game 7 hours ago. Kind of thinking about which deck or like variation should I play. I played here a lot of with the Hunter version. Here I played a lot of with the Bats version. I wasn't like really sure which is the best deck. I kind of decided to play like with the Zap version because there are a lot of Miner Wallbreaker players out there. Like I saw Moogie playing a deck. I saw like Mormon Light plays the deck. He was also playing his deck, Niku. And they were like Volstochter's playing deck. So in the year, so I think in top lane, my top 10, Zap might be the better version, but overall the Fireball really helps a lot, especially with the Hunter against Lavaloon player. So I would say I'm gonna see you in the game. Let's go, guys. Here we go, guys. See you in the game against Rakan Lava. And it's always about for me switching out decks and top ladder because like I don't really want to get sniped. I got sniped earlier from Anaban, so I'm always trying to switch up decks, make sure I'm playing different decks on top layer. I just don't want to get sniped, so switching up decks is really nice. And kind of knowing, okay, you can face this guy, so I just want to make sure I have like the best deck against 4 out of the 5 players. So I'm always trying to switch out my spells. I Hunter in, Hunter out. So you guys gonna see who play against Rakan Lava. And yeah, the reason I kind of played the Hunter version, I was like top 100 in the world, but I pushed with the Hunter version in the top 50 in the world, or like in the top 20 in the world, because it's just so solid overall, because there's so many Lava players. I think I played against Rakan twice, I played against some beatdown players, so overall I just think the version is way better in like the mid, like not mid ladder, it's like top 100 in the world, but I think you guys know what I meant with to say that. So this is why I'm always switching decks, because I don't really like to get countered. But what is the best Miner Wallbreaker deck in general? I can't really tell to you guys. Like, if you play a lot against beatdown, put the Hunter in. If you have the feeling, yo, you're just playing against cycle decks and they're not having a lot of times like a zap in it or the Devoid Delivery, you just want to go in with the bats version, because it's way better to apply pressure. Also better against graveyard decks in my opinion, or like especially against most of the graveyard deck, because you cannot cycle them so easily. And this is the problem which you have with this deck. Sometimes you get in the awkward cycle against Expo as well. It's not easy, or not as easy as with the other versions. So every time if I show a deck, I have some spells in it or like some cards, you can always switch it up. If you have the feeling you play more against that, put the card out, switch the card in. It's always fine. If I'm showing a deck, it doesn't have to be the best deck for you guys. It's a good deck which I'm always showing. Otherwise, like I'm saying, it's not a good deck, but you can always try to switch up cards to make it perfect for you guys. So we go for Miner on the right tower. And I think we're going in with a Hunter in the back. Yes, Hunter is coming down here. And this is just a good matchup, honestly. This is just a really good matchup. Here we go for Fireball. We're going for Knight here. We're going in with a Miner in the back. So Wallbreaker split. And Wallbreaker the pressure, like it's just really easy, I would say, because he still needs to get my tower. And at the same time, like, you know, Hunter is so good, like against Lava, this makes the matchup completely different with all with bats. It's just like an impossible matchup, it feels like. With the Hunter, it's a really good matchup, it feels like impossible for him. So I think I'm gonna fireball that. And now I try to get the minor catch, but I didn't. He plays it to the side. Great minor placement. Maybe I'm still gonna lock here because I want him to use the arrows as well. If the minor wouldn't have got the one hit, he would have been in a great position, but he still needs to go in with barbarians and defense. So I think we're just gonna fireball. I think we got a fireball in time. Great fireball usage from us. And yeah, and right now it's just game. He can't really do anything anymore. If he's gonna lava in the back, I'm just gonna punch him for that. So he still needs to go for skeleton drinks against Spear Golem. It's not really what the lava player wants to do. They always wanna chill with the elixir and don't really wanna overcommit here. And I think we're going in here with the wall breaker. And the miner, let's go. And miner's wallbreaker's connecting. GG's well played. It's just about spell cycle now. Log, hunter, wallbreaker, bomb tower. Make like sure to clean up the game. He's not gonna defend the wallbreaker because he thought like maybe with the kinker helping, it's not gonna do anything. We're gonna take it up. GG's well played. Gonna see you guys in the next one. Now I'm gonna show you guys a game against Wolf's Tochter. Really, really good opponent, German player. And I would say this is like one of the harder matchups because I have the hunter version, he has the bats version, so he has the cheaper cycles. So I lost the matchup earlier against Basotto, but I could have also won against him. I didn't play my best there, but we are going in here with a hunter on his miner, and we are doing good so far. Nice, the game just started. What is important in a minor wallbreaker mirror matchup? For sure, which is really important, you don't want to overcommit in single elixir time. This is like the worst thing you can do. You don't want to spend too much elixir. You don't want to get punished, especially when the opponent has like cards like bats. This is even more annoying because like hunter isn't really a punishing card. You can always defend it. But bats, if you have a really bad cycle, they go with minor bats and just go with wallbreaker to bridge or two elixir, you might be in some trouble. So this is the most important thing. Another important thing is always try to switch up your minor placements. You don't want to go with the minor on the same spot like three times. So sure, you can do it twice. Kind of think about what is the opponent going to do. How is he going to react to a minor? But most of the time, you want to switch it up. Like all the time, you want to switch it up. Make sure your opponent is not able to do anything against that. So, I think the miner is connecting there. We're just going to go for log. And we're going with wallbreaker at the river. So, we're going with a hunter. And I think, yeah, we need to go for bomb tower because that was a great miner decision by him. He played the miner onto the right because the miner was tanking to the left tower. So, the bomb tower wasn't like what the left tower, even with a log, wouldn't have been able to kill the wallbreakers because the tower was still shooting a mine on the right side. So we go for mine on the tower, and you guys see every time he's playing bats on that, he's gonna get like a plus trade. He gets still a counter push, and at the same time I make minus two elixirs. So if he would have gone for a log prediction, I would have been so dead, but he didn't. That's good. So we go for miner here with a 90. I wouldn't really recommend this miner placement for you guys because by the way, I was kind of lucky that the wallbreaker got shot by the tower because I don't really like the minor placement. I don't really like the minor placement. The reason is because I feel like we can, like, with retargeting the miner with the knight at this position, like, you're not gonna get minor chip damage besides like one hit if the opponent's doing well with the miner. So this is not really a thing to do. I don't really agree with this fireball. Also, it's on a lower tower, on a higher HP tower. So we go for miner, we go for fireball also. So we're coming back here. Even looked like a really aggressive move, so he's gonna do the same. We're going with that, and we're just gonna go here with low spear gums. He's gonna lock that, but we're perfectly fine. We're in a good position. I'm really happy about that. So I think we're just going with wallbreaker high. Go for mine in the back. Yeah, really great defense, and that was overall perfect defense. So that my hunter is not gonna get another shot, I think. No, it's not. So we still need to go spear gums. Spear gums are cleaning everything up here, yeah, but we are fine. We are fine. We know triple next time he has a cheaper cycle of the spells and stuff, but overall we should have a good matchup. So we go for mine in the back. And I don't really think, yeah, one wallbreaker is connecting. So we still need to go for hunter. He's gonna fireball predict here. He thought maybe I'm gonna play the hunter there, but my hunter's doing a great job cleaning up everything. And right now we're in a really comfortable spot. We are up by elixir, we have a knight on the field, and I think I'm just gonna let them go. I'm like, okay, I don't really care. We're going for mine on his tower. And let's see. Mine is connecting to his tower. We're just gonna go for log also because I know he has to defend it. I don't really think this, yeah, it's enough. So we need to go for log. And we go also with spear goblins. We're going in with are we going for hunter in the back? No, we go for hunter high because we don't want to give him fireball value. So we go for minor wallbreaker here. Miner's connecting, he still needs to go for bomb tower. And we are chilling. We are chilling. And I even think we're gonna fireball here because I just want to get the spell damage going on. Just the spell side. Going with spear goblins like that. He is just gonna go for knight. I think I'm gonna play a high hunter here. Yes, high hunter, and go with the mine on the tower. Why I'm going with the mine on the tower? Because his knight is out of cycle, his spear comes out of cycle. So what is he supposed to do? He can't do anything. We're going for mine on a safe spot, I think, right now. I'm just gonna let the wall breaker go. I know it's gonna be a ton of damage, but he's not gonna be in spell cycle range yet. So we go for mine on the right side. Mine is doing a great job. Fireball Lock is enough. Fireball Lock is coming down. GG's well played. We're taking the cup against Wolf's Tochter, and I'm gonna see you in the next game. Let's go, guys. So, guys, I think it's the last game I'm gonna share to you guys today against Agony King. Really not easy matchup at all. He's playing Sparky, Giant Sparky, so I'm not really sure which I should go for the season end. Top 10 would be the best, honestly. Like, if I get a chance and like number 3 and I need one more game for number 1, I would for sure go to number 1, but I really want to get to top 10 because top 10 is important for the CL ranking points. If you finish top 10, you're getting a ton of points and you need the points for qualifying for the CL World Finals. So I really want to get a top 10 finish for that. And if you guys want to check out, I'm going to do a season end stream on Twitch, mainly on German. But if you have any questions, you want to check in there by say hello or watch the gameplay, make sure to check out my Twitch, twitch.tv/modernroyale. I'm going to link it, hopefully, if I'm not forgetting it, in the description. But I'm starting there Sunday night, like I would say like 12 hours before the season ends. I'm gonna stream the full season end there. So make sure to check it out if you wanna watch me playing against the best players in the world at season end. And yeah, I'm just hoping I am gonna be able to get a good finish. So we go with mine in the back. And he is just gonna fireball that. And this is not easy matchup. Like, Kegoni King is a really good Sparky player. I think he got a number 2 finish. And we are playing with, you have this Spear Goblins version with the Hunter this time once again. Yeah, so much beatdown currently in this situation. Or like in the, like, I feel like it's completely different. In the top 10 meta, it's completely different than like the top 50 meta. Top 50, a lot of gold and a lot of lava. On top 10, more like cycle decks, honestly. So this is just how I feel in top layer. Let me know what you're playing against. Is it like most of them golem? Are you playing most of them against lava hound? Let me know. Really interested in seeing this opinion. So by the way, that was so unfortunate. His build is cleaning up everything. Spark's cranking with 1 HP. He's still gonna zap that. So I still need to go for Warbreaker Kite to kite them back. But that was just overall unfortunate. We still need to go for Log. So I'm like, can we win this game? Can we win this game? But you guys will see, he's gonna do one big mistake in the future and we do like one really great play. So we instantly go for mine on a safe spot. He's gonna drop a Sparky and you guys see the miners chipping away a lot. And you can, people are kinda underestimating, like, it's 70 damage per hit. So really taking that. So I am gonna go in with a fireball, I think. Yes, he's also going for fireball on the bomb tower. I'm gonna go Spearguards, going for Hunter, great Hunter. And he's gonna zap this, I think. So we still need to go for Wallbreaker, but I'm completely fine with that. I think I'm gonna go for Miner instant to the left. Yeah, just wanna make sure. If he's gonna go Spark, he can't redo it. And right now I'm seeing, okay, he uses his Electrozet, so he's like kinda caring right now. So he's not having like that much Elixir. So I'm trying to go in on the left side here. I think I'm also going, am I going with Wallbreaker here? That was like a kind of bad heal spirit. So he still needs to fireball that. Maybe I shouldn't give him that much fireball value, but you guys see the knight is still going to get one big, huge shot. So I'm going to go with that, I'm going to go with that. And now I'm new, he's going to zap it. So we go for a predictive prediction. Not really a prediction, but we go for a preemptive knight in front of that to protect my hunter. We go for my Wallbreaker in the back. We know our miner is going to chip away 100%. So we're going to go for Log. Also, my Log plus Miner's doing a great job here. And we are doing fine. He's gonna do that. That was like a bad timing. I played the Knight at the same time as he played the Sparky. So that was unfortunate. It was a bit unlucky, but I don't really want to complain because we are still in a good spot. We go for Miner back. He's gonna catch it. So we go for Bomb Tower like that. Gonna also go for High Hunter down. Wanna give him Fireball value. And I know even if the Sparky gets a hit, I don't really care at all. But it doesn't even get a hit, so I think I'm gonna go in now with, yeah, he didn't spark here. I thought he's gonna sparking, so we go for Miner Wallbreaker. We're gonna lock this, and look at the damage the Miner does. So we're completely fine here, and he already knows, okay, he needs to do something special. But you guys will see what he's gonna do now. Spark at the river, and he will try to nade everything together. So I knew that. I'm gonna go for Knight High, and I'm gonna go for Bomb Tower as well, just to make sure we're not gonna do anything like wrong. We go for Miner, he's gonna dare to do that. We're gonna go for Fireball, and just about spell cycling. Now GG's well played, we're taking it up, we're currently 11th global, and we wanna get a top 10 finish. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, just one live game, but you guys know, season end is always tricky, doing it in English, but I still hope you enjoyed this one. What's the best Miner Warbird deck right now? I don't really know. I'm trying out different things. I'm trying out some stuff, but you guys see right now, we're currently number 11 in the world, or like number 13 right now. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed today's one. I'm going to see you guys tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching. Love you guys. Goodbye.